Hey everyone, Lynn from Hypotenuse AI here. If you're an e-commerce company or you just sell online, whether it's services or listings, chances are you have a ton of descriptions you need to get through. Well, with the help of AI, you can now streamline that process and create content faster with automatically generated descriptions. In this video, I'll show you how to use Hypotenuse AI to batch create copy, refresh your content faster, and go a little bit into how Hypotenuse AI helps you turn your features into benefits. Let's get started. First off, you can find product descriptions in the sidebar right here. And once you click on this, you land in this page that prompts you to create a catalog. What a catalog really is a way for you to keep organized, whether it's by seasons or whether it's by different batches of products or services you'll like to create descriptions for. So we'll go ahead and create a new catalog, and I'll label this with today's date to keep ourselves organized. Once you do so, you'll see this option to import products right here, and that will give you two options to add a single product or to import multiple products. We'll start with adding a single product, and I can show you what the process of generating one product looks like. Once you click on that, you'll see a card created that represents one product. Great, so we've created a single product and you can see the fields that our AI requires here. You can add in the name of the product, your brand, as well as product features. What product features really are either the specifications of your product or service, for instance, the color, the size, or the shape of your product. Or it can also be unique selling points that you want the AI to write about. Our AI will take all these and then convert your features to benefits for a high conversion description. You'll also see the advanced options section right here, which gives you the ability to add in any SEO keywords. I typically recommend adding just one primary keyword to avoid diluting the intent of your page too much. But you can also add up to two semantically similar keywords to give your page a bit more breadth. Our AI will do its best to add the keyword directly verbatim, but due to how natural language processing works, it could also edit it to make it fit more naturally into the sentence structure. So you can go ahead and generate a description here. You don't have to only write about a product as well, but you can write descriptions about services or about listings. So for instance, if I'm typing a 2-bedroom house here with maybe, you know, great natural sunlight and maybe it's west facing. Maybe I'm looking for two bath. And I can go ahead and generate right here. So over here, you'll see that the AI has generated our descriptions and the SEO keyword that we added in is highlighted as well. So if it's added verbatim, our AI will highlight this directly, but if it's rephrased, it will be naturally in the description itself. Great, so now that you know what inputs the AI requires, we'll go ahead and import multiple products. And you can see how easy it is to import thousands of product features at once. So let's just go ahead and delete this. And I'll go back to my import products button right here. So this time, instead of adding one product, I'll go ahead and import multiple products. Over here, you'll see a drop zone where I can add in a CSV or even images. We get quite a few questions on how images work or when to use images. So images work best when you have not many product descriptions and you would like our AI to automatically tag your images based on what it can see in the photo. This works best for products with well-defined outlines and shapes. So for instance, if it's something like a ball bearing, it's not quite easy to tell what the image is. It typically won't work so well. I will say that probably 95% of users can get by with just uploading product specifications. So onto the CSV file itself. Over here, you'll see a sample CSV template that you can download. And I'll go ahead and show you what this looks like now. Great, so over here, you'll see a column for the title, a column for the image source, which is simply the URL to the image. Again, this is completely optional. Your brand, any product specifications under the tags column, a SKU if you want to import it to keep organized, as well as the SEO keywords that you want to import for that product. So we'll go ahead and import this CSV directly now. So you can see here, we've imported three separate products on different cards with the title, the brand, different product features, SEO keywords, as well as the SKU for you to keep organized. At any time, you can search for a particular product title or even your SKU if you need to keep organized. If you need to search for a particular product. Alternatively, if you have your own custom CSV format, you don't have to use the sample template file. All you have to do is to go to import multiple products. From here, I'm going to select a file that I've downloaded as a sample file from WooCommerce. If we detect that your change in file looks different, then we'll give you a message. But otherwise, this is actually safe to ignore. And I'll just go to next. Over here, you'll see our field mapping screen. What this means is that you can map the titles or the tags from your file into Hypotenuse itself. So I can go ahead and change this to, I know that it's the name. If there is a brand, it might not be a brand here. I might want to just leave it blank in this case. And I can even import my SKU so that when I export my file, I can easily match it back to my original CMS. In the tags view or the product features view, this is where I can also just import anything that could be useful information for the AI to generate content from. In this case, things like the product type, things like what the category might be. I might even want to import the original description. And that might be about it for now. So I can go ahead and submit this file. And we'll start the import process. See here, you can see that we've imported the original description. We have the product title. We have some of the categories here. Now with the 10 products that I've imported, I can go ahead and generate everything at once for this. And you can do this by clicking on the bulk generate button right here. Here you have options to either generate descriptions for everything in the new tab, just this page itself, which gives you 10 products at a time, or you can manually select products you want to generate a description for. In this case, I'll go ahead and generate descriptions for all 10 products. Here, number of credits are calculated for you to check just before you generate your product itself. So you can see that the generation has started for all my products. In this case, if you have a big catalog or you're generating, 1,000 at once, this is the best time to grab a coffee and take a break. Now I can see that descriptions are starting to come in. Over here, you can see that we give you two different descriptions to work with, called creative as well as fresh. These are simply different names that we have given for different tones of voice that the AI has been trained on. AI has been trained on many different copywriting formulas and best practices on high conversion copy, which you can see reflected in the descriptions themselves. You can see the original description still stays in case you want to reference anything from it as you edit your copy. So now that you have all your descriptions in place, this is where the workflow comes in for you to manage and organize the editing of your descriptions. Let's say I want to select this description and let's say I really like this description and I want to use this and export this one eventually. Here, I might want to make a little bit of adjustment. Maybe I think that, you know, amazing is a bit of a overstatement. And perhaps I actually quite like this line and I want to combine my description. What I can do now is to select this product and then to mark it as done. When you have a lot of products, this helps you to keep organized by working in a team and helping you to tackle different products in different batches. So once you've marked it as done, it moves over to the Done tab. And this is where you'll want to download everything that has been completed once you've edited and confirmed your final copy. Once I'm done with my copy, I can go ahead and export my copy. I can choose to either export every product that I've had or just products in the Done tab here. I can also download either all the copy that I've generated, which are unselected descriptions, or I can also include products that do not have a selected description. Great, so now you can see that in your export, your original data is all still saved while your generated description will be appended to the end of your file in the description column. This makes it really easy to be able to just upload this directly to your CMS after. So that's if you wanted to generate descriptions from scratch just based on your product features. What if you want to refresh your copy or base it off an existing piece of copy? That's where you can import your description and use it as a base for rewriting. This is especially helpful for things like supplier descriptions or past season copy that you might just want to tweak and update for current events or different seasons. This is how it'll work. Similarly, you can go to importing multiple products. I'll use the same file that I have again. And this time I'll want to import my original description. So here you can see in the original description column, I'll want to import this in as a base for the AI to generate new copy of. Similarly, I'll go through my field mapping, but in this case, what I can do is to just directly search for the description field to import this in. And I'll go ahead and submit it. Great. So over here, now you can see for these products, I've already imported the original description here. And this is all the AI really needs to rewrite your description from scratch. As an example, you can go ahead and generate a description for this one. Over here, you can see that these descriptions have been rewritten simply based on this original description. You might be thinking about adding SEO keywords to your descriptions as well. Well, that's where this advanced options sections come in. For instance, I might want to rank for the keyword lightweight yoga strap. Great. So once you've added in the SEO keyword, you'll see that if the SEO keyword gets added directly and exactly as it is, it will get highlighted in your copy so that you can see and monitor whether a keyword is missing or not. Finally, you can also use the prep features section to add in some details about a current promotion that you might be running or a current event that's going on. So for instance, it could be for the holiday season. Here I can say it's great for a holiday gift or stocking stuffer for the yogi in your life. Once again, I can go ahead and generate. And I can see that the AI has already integrated that into the copy, mentioning that this could be the perfect gift for the yogi in your life, or that this could be an ideal gift or stocking stuffer. One other handy thing that this can be used for is for localization. Over here, you can find the language section and you can either choose a different input or output language to generate different descriptions in. So for instance, I might want to generate some German descriptions while keeping my inputs on the left in English. Go ahead and regenerate. And you'll see descriptions appear in German. If you have a particular theme or you have a particular keyword that you'd like to add in for the entire catalog, you can click on the Edit Catalog button here. And under the Advanced Options, you can add something that will apply to the entire catalog. So for instance, if you wanted a theme for this catalog based on the holiday season, you can always say great for the holiday season as a gift. And this will actually apply as a product feature to every single product in this catalog. A couple of other things here that will make your workflow a bit easier is this folder button. With AI being what it is, it's not always the case that you will get a description back for all of the products, and some of them may fail to generate, especially if there is some data that looks different or the AI doesn't quite understand all the data that's being sent to it. Here's where, after bulk generating, you can filter by any products that have failed to generate and either check through their data and regenerate everything or to simply try the regeneration over again. You can also filter it by anything that's been generated or anything that has been not generated as well. So that's it on how to create descriptions in bulk, including importing existing specifications or descriptions, as well as exporting them to a CSV file so that you can import them to your CMS. Hope that helps, and let us know if you have any questions, comments, or feedback.